Hello and welcome back to the Tech Blackboard. Let's get started with today's episode. And today I have some mixed bag of questions for you. Real exam questions with the answers for AWS Cloud Practitioner exam. And I will also share some AWS official documentation so that you can validate the answer and also do some self-study. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started. So let's begin today's episode with question number 86, part 9. The question says that a large company has multiple departments. Each department has its own AWS account. Now, each department has purchased Amazon EC2 reserved instances, and some of the departments do not use all the reserved instances that they have purchased, while other departments need more reserved instances than they have purchased. So the company needs to manage the AWS accounts for all the departments so that the departments can share the reserved instances. Which AWS service or the tool should the company use to meet these requirements? Your options are option A, AWS System Manager. Option B is Cost Explorer. Option C is AWS Trusted Advisor. And option D is AWS Organizations. And the correct answer for this question is option D, AWS Organization. Now friends, I discussed AWS Organization in the part 4 as well, and also took some of the questions on AWS Organization in the part 7. So you can check both part 4 and part 7, but do not worry, I will share some documentation in this episode as well. Let's move on with the next question. Question number 87 says that which central governance and management capabilities does AWS Organization enable? Your options are option A, maintain a secure environment with policies and management of AWS security services. Option B is locally manage policies across multiple AWS accounts. Option C is audit your EC2 for compliance. And option D is audit your environment for compliance. And lastly, option E says view and manage cost with consolidated billing. And the correct answer for this question is option A, maintain a secure environment with policies and management of AWS security services. And the second correct option is option D, audit your environment for compliance. And finally, the third capability that AWS Organization enable is option E, view and manage cost with consolidated billing. So let's understand AWS Organization in a little bit more detail. Here in the documentation, it says that AWS Organizations help you centrally govern your environment as you scale your workloads on AWS. Now, whether you are growing startup or a large enterprise, Organizations helps you programmatically create new accounts and allocate resources, simplify billing by setting up single payment method for all your account, create groups of account to organize your workflows and apply policies to these groups for governance. Here you can also read the question that we just validated. And the question was, which central governance and management capabilities does AWS Organization enable? Here you can read all the capabilities, for example, automate AWS account, maintain a secure environment, govern access to AWS services, centrally manage policies, audit your environment, view and manage costs, and lastly, configure AWS services across multiple platforms. So please learn and understand all these capabilities. You will get some questions based on this topic. The links for all the documentation that I'm referring in this video is available in the description box. Question number 88 says, a group of AWS account within an organization is, your options are an organizational unit, option B is AWS manager account, and lastly AWS control tower. And of course, the correct answer for this question is option A, an organizational unit. So what is an organizational unit? Well, organizational unit is a group of AWS account within an organization. And friends, also remember that an organizational unit can also contain other organizational units. So kind of hierarchy here. For example, you can group all the accounts that belong to same department into departmental unit. Similarly, you can group all the accounts running security services into security organizational unit. So this is how, my friends, organizational unit helps you create a hierarchy within all your accounts. So in case you're working for a big organization, then this service provides a neat way to manage all your accounts. Now let's move on to the question number 89. It says, which Amazon S3 storage class has the lowest cost? Your options are S3 intelligent tearing, option B is S3 standard, and lastly S3 glacier deep archive. And the correct answer for this question is option C. So basically S3 glacier deep archive has the lowest cost among all the classes in Amazon S3 storage. And in case you want to understand more on Amazon S3 storage classes, this is the documentation. Here you can see we have various storage classes. We have S3 intelligent tiering. We also have S3 standard. We have S3 standard infrequent access. And moving on, we also have one zonal infrequent access. And then we also have glacier instant retrieval. And finally, the answer that we picked is Amazon S3 glacier deep archive. And here I want to give you one more documentation. This one, here you can read that Amazon S3 glacier storage class has the lowest cost and millisecond access. So please read out all the documentation to understand all the storage classes in Amazon. It's really important service, not just from the exam perspective, but also in your daily working on Amazon Cloud. Now let's move on to the next question. Question number 90 says that which of the following services has a global scope? Your options are EC2, IAM, Lambda, and lastly S3. And the correct answer for this question is option B, IAM. So friends, IAM is a global service that encompasses all the regions. And just so you know, in AWS, all the services are broadly categorized into three scopes: zonal services, regional services, and global services. And I will take more questions on all these concepts in the next episode. But for now, let's move on to the next question. Question number 91 says that which of the following is the definition of cloud computing? Your options are rapidly develop, test, and launch software application. And option B is automatic and quick ability to acquire resources as you need them and release resources when you no longer need them. Option C says cloud computing is an on-demand delivery of IT resources over the internet with pay-as-you-go pricing. And lastly, buying and owning and maintaining physical data centers and the servers. And the correct answer for this question is option C. Cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of IT resources over the internet with pay-as-you-go pricing. And of course, you can validate the answer on this very documentation from AWS on what is cloud computing. Here it clearly marks down that cloud computing is the on-demand delivery of the IT resources over the internet with pay-as-you-go pricing. You can read more on this documentation on who is using cloud computing. And then you can also understand what are the benefits of cloud computing. For example, we have agility, we also have elasticity, then you have cost saving, so on and so forth. So a great documentation for anyone who is starting with AWS cloud computing. Now friends, let's move our focus on the questions based on AWS shared responsibility model. Trust me, you will get quite a handful of questions from this area. So here comes the question number 92. It says, under the AWS shared responsibility model, AWS is responsible for which security related task? And your options are option A, lifecycle management of IAM credentials, option B, physical security of global infrastructure, option C is encryption of Amazon EBS volumes, and lastly, firewall configuration. And the correct answer for this question is option B, physical security of global infrastructure. And friends, once again, I want to re-emphasize, in these kind of questions, always read the question very carefully and understand if the question is asking about AWS responsibility or the question is asking about customer responsibility, because certainly answer will change accordingly. Moving on with the question number 93, it says, what is an AWS responsibility under the AWS shared responsibility model? Once again, please note, we are talking about AWS responsibility. And your options are configure the security group rules that determine which ports are open on an Amazon EC2 Linux instance. And then option B is ensure the security of the internal network in AWS data center. Option C is patch the guest operating system with the latest security patches on Amazon EC2. And lastly, turn on the server-side encryption for Amazon S3 buckets. And the correct answer for this question is option B, ensure the security of the internal network in AWS data centers. So friends, I'm sure that you're following the suggestions that I gave in the starting of this video series. Please read the questions with me, understand all the options, take a pause, select your answer and match up your answer with the answer I give. In case you feel there is some discrepancy or in case you have some contrary view, please let me know in the comment section or email me at connectus@thetechblackboard.com. Moving on with the question number 94, it says, according to the AWS shared responsibility model, which of the following is the customer's obligation? And I'm sure you have already noted, this time we are talking about customer's obligation. Your options are patching underlying infrastructure. Option B is physical security. Option C is patching Amazon EC2 instances. And lastly, patching network infrastructure. And the correct answer for this question is option C, patching Amazon EC2 instances. And friends, as I've mentioned many times, that AWS shared responsibility model is one really important area, and you will surely get some questions around this. So I will bring loads of questions around this area because we have loads of customer responsibility and loads of AWS responsibility. So you must understand the distinction between the two. It's not just for the exam sake, but you also understand, because this will be really handy when you're actually working on Amazon Cloud. So please do not shy away and subscribe to the channel so that you get the timely notifications. And with that, let's move on to the next question. Question number 95 says that which of the following is the component of AWS global infrastructure? Your options are Amazon Alexa, option B is AWS Regions, and option C is Amazon Lightsail. And lastly, we have Amazon Organizations. And the correct answer for this question is option B, AWS Regions. So by the way, what are the major components in AWS global infrastructure? Well, all of them are listed here. First of all, we have AWS regions. Then inside AWS regions, we have availability zones with data centers and edge locations. Needless to say, I have already covered so many questions around this concept. But then my friends, I have some new questions from this area or this concept that I will cover in the subsequent parts. So friends, I'm sure that you're learning quite a lot on AWS Cloud Practitioner exam. And if yes, pressing the like button is one sure short way to appreciate our efforts. And that's all for today. I will see you in the next video. Till then, stay fit, keep learning, and thanks for watching.